After studying this module, you shall be able to 1. Know the concept of project life cycle, 2. Learn the importance of project life cycle, 3. Identify the stages in project life cycle, and lastly, evaluate the project life cycle. To begin with, projects go through a certain life cycle. It is important to understand the concept of project life cycle, its importance, and the stages in project life cycle. Besides, it is also critical to evaluate the project life cycle. A clear understanding of these phases allows managers and executives to maintain control of the project more efficiently. Firstly, we will discuss project life cycle. Projects have a definite beginning and ending. Project life cycle refers to logical sequence of activities to accomplish project's goals. Irrespective of size and complexity, all projects map to the following life cycle stages, wherein each stage represents grouping of similar activities which leads towards effective working as well as effective arrangement of resources by project managers for each stage. It also helps in effective measurement of objectives and justify their decision to move ahead, correct, or terminate. Stages are typically sequential, where the prior stage is essentially completed before the beginning of the next stage. However, stages sometimes do not have clear-cut end dates, and some activities in an early stage of the project will continue into the later stages. On the other hand, some activities can be overlapped with the latter stages. There are 6 major stages of project. These include identification, initiation, project planning and appraisal, project execution, project closure, and evaluation. In the starting phase of a project, in which the outputs and critical success factors are defined, followed by planning phase, characterized by breaking down the project into smaller parts or tasks, and execution phase, in which the project plan is executed, and lastly, a closure or exit phase that marks the completion of the project. The knowledge, skill, and experience needed for the project can vary in each phase. During the early phases of a project, the project leader needs abstract skills, the capability to build a team, and the know-how to build a project draft. On the other hand, during exit, the project leadership provides a high degree of motivation and appropriate attention towards details of the project. Project managers must organize the project phases according to industry needs, as each industry has its specific requirements, and the needs of the industries also differ as far as their life cycle management methodology is concerned. Paying close attention to these particular needs depicts the efficiency of the project manager. Next, we will discuss the phases of project life cycle. Project life cycle has got the phases as shown in the figure: identification, initiation, project planning and appraisal, project execution, project closure, and lastly, evaluation. The first phase is identification. This stage determines the nature and scope of the project. This stage needs a critical attention, as the success or failure of the project depends heavily on this stage. If the project is not identified properly, it is unlikely that the project will meet the business objectives ever.
The major donor agencies like World Bank will place major emphasis on project identification stage as an important stage for project success. In-depth experience and knowledge of local conditions can be important source of project formulation along with technical surveys, which helps in identifying the feasible projects. Domestically, public sector projects are usually derived from the planning process or from political imperatives of national governments and their agencies, whereas private sector projects usually arise from the identification of opportunity for profits. There are certain factors which complicates the decision at identification stage, such as conflicting interest between the parties involved, like government, public, local bodies, external beneficiaries, etc., and varying level of capability in project formulation. Next phase is initiation. Project Management Institute, that is PMI, the world's leading not-for-profit professional membership association for the project program and portfolio management profession, labels project initiation phase as starting the project. Includes all the activities necessary to begin planning the project. Projects that are shortlisted in the identification stage need to be prepared and analyzed before the funds are allocated to them. This is very crucial stage of any project, as it is the phase in which the project manager defines the scope of the project and hires his team. In this phase, clearly defined scope and effective team will help the project manager to achieve success. The six key activities are required to be undertaken for the successful completion of this phase are: 1. Develop a business case. Business case justifies the initiation of the project, describing about the cost benefit as well as identifying the risk associated with each available option and recommend alternative solution for the project to the sponsor. Business case document provides the full confidence to the sponsor by justifying that the given solution is the most viable solution. 2. Undertake a feasibility study. Feasibility study is very critical for any project, as it is conducted to see the likelihood of the project, whether it can be carried forward or there is a need to terminate the project. If there is any doubt that whether the available option should be adopted or not, then the feasibility study clears this doubt. During feasibility studies, various assessment methods are undertaken and assure the viability of the solution from the given alternative solutions. 3. Establish the project charter. Project charter helps in defining the scope of the project. Charter defines the parameters within which the project must be delivered. The charter defines the project vision, mission, and objective, as well as the stakeholders associated with that. It is also known as project definition document. It also defines the structure of the project. 4. The project team appointment. Project teams are appointed because without them, the project cannot be completed. Herein, the jobs and responsibilities of the team are decided for achieving the target. Set up the project office. The setting up of project office is very essential for achieving the project objectives. It is a physical premises within which the project staff resides. The office contains the technology and infrastructure required to support the project. And lastly, perform a phase review. The project review report is prepared at the end of the initiation phase. It is prepared in order to show the sponsor whether the project is able to achieve its objectives till date or not. The report is placed in front of sponsor in order to get further approval. It is critical to depict the sponsor that the project is running smoothly. Next step we will discuss is the project planning and appraisal. The project planning phase is described by the PMI as the work wherein the cost plans and budgets are prepared. It includes developing detailed staffing, procurement, and project control plans. A project brief is prepared to describe the project's aims and objectives, its main issues, and the timelines within which its implementation and processing is perceived. Consideration of alternatives is important at this stage as early signaling mechanism for choosing the worthwhile projects. Through detailed analysis, projects are likely to be shaped and redefined to take them a step closer under realistic conditions under which they may be implemented. In this phase, the more focus is to develop a plan about successful execution of the project. Even while the major planning activities take place during this period, but still the project continuously keeps on adjusting the environmental challenges and opportunities. In this way, planning activities continue during the entire life of the project. Now, the following steps must be followed during the planning process. Create a project plan. Project plan is used to take care of the budget, cost, as well as the timelines of the project. It shows the tasks, activities, and the requirement of resources. In short, it is blue of the activities from beginning to end required to complete the project. Create a resource plan. The resource plan is used to identify the quantity of labor, equipment, and materials needed to deliver your project. Appropriate resources plan helps the project manager with budgeting and forecasting project expenditure along with successful approval from project sponsor. Create a financial plan. Financial plan helps in setting budget against which you measure your expenditure by identifying the project finance needed to achieve the project objectives. The financial plan summarizes the total expenses to be incurred across the project. The sound financial plan will help you to get project finance to deliver the project in time. Create a quality plan. The quality control and quality assurance schedules are prepared to set quality targets to ensure that the deliverable produced must meet the requirements of your customers. It helps you to monitor and control the level of quality produced by the project. By using quality assurance and quality control techniques, the project manager can create a comprehensive quality management, giving your customer a high degree of confidence that you will succeed. Create a risk plan. Risk management plan helps you to identify the risk and implement a plan to reduce them. It lists of all foreseeable risks, their ranking and priority, the preventative and contingent actions, along with the process for tracking them, ensuring that all risks are mitigated as quickly as possible. Create acceptance plan. Acceptance plan is a schedule of tasks that are required to gain the customer's acceptance that what you have produced is satisfactory. The acceptance plan includes a list of the deliverables, the acceptance test activities, the criteria and standards to be met, and the plan for their completion. Create communication plan. The communication plan describes how you intend to communicate the right messages to the right people at the right time. Within the communication plan, the communication goals, stakeholders, and strategies, activities, and time frames are described. The best time to perform communication planning is during the startup phase of a project. This will ensure that your communication plan includes the tasks needed to communicate effectively throughout the entire project life cycle. Create procurement plan. The procurement plan helps you to procure products and services from external suppliers. The plan helps in procuring the right supplies from the supplier at right time. By using the plan, you can quickly and easily define your procurement requirements. The procurement requirement, the method, and the time of your delivery. Contact the suppliers. The supplier is contacted in order to get the supplies of the product. Herein, the cost as well as the time is the critical K factor. While deciding about the supplier, usually the tenders process is followed in order to select the supplier. The supplier who gives the most economical and viable bid in terms of quality, quantity, time, and cost, and fulfills other terms and conditions important to the contract are selected. Project review form. The project review form is filled at the end of planning process in order to review whether the project has achieved the objectives till date. The review may be conducted by team manager or some authorized person not related to the project document when it is prepared for future approval. Project appraisal appraises whether the project is feasible in terms of financials and other resources vis-a-vis its benefits. Appraisal covers four major aspects of the project: technical, institutional, financial, and economic. Let us discuss them in detail. Technical aspects. Technical appraisal of the project involves its engineering and design feasibility study, as it is concerned with plant location, layout and technology used, cost estimate and their relation to engineering and designs on which they are based, proposed procurement arrangements, the potential impact on human and physical environment, and other resources required. Institutional aspects. Institutional appraisal is concerned with human capability and institutional framework in which projects are implemented. Many projects have limitations at human and institutional level, also called soft inputs. Therefore, project appraisal requires careful and sensitive considerations of institutional dimension and local conditions. Financial and economic aspect. Financial appraisal deals with the financial adequacy of funds, the financial viability of the project, borrowers' ability to service debt, procedure for recovering investment and operating cost, and assessing the payback of the project along with its capability to return a profit, whereas economic appraisal is concerned with whether the project contributes to the aggregate income as well as towards social welfare Next, we will discuss the project execution phase. The execution phase deals with carrying out the work and includes the major activities needed to accomplish the work of the project. In this, the physical project deliverables are built and presented to the customer. It is usually the longest and critical phase in project life cycles and consumes most energy and resources. A range of management processes are required to control and monitor the project at this stage. The steps followed at the project execution stage can be explained as: perform time management. The time management process describes time management procedure, explaining how to use time sheets and time management logs to record time spent. By using the process, the project manager can control the time taken by the staff to complete the project, increasing the chances of delivering on time. It is the best way to monitor the record time actually spent on the project versus planned time. Perform cost management. Project cost management process helps project manager to monitor, report, and control all expenses within the project by recording up-to-date cost of information, ensuring that the project can be delivered within the budget. Perform quality management. The quality management process, with the help of quality assurance, quality control, and continuous quality improvement, ensures that the deliverables produced actually meets the requirements of the customer. It helps to improve the quality of deliverables in the project. Perform risk management. The risk management process is performed to identify, monitor, and control risk, which restricts the team to achieve its objectives. The risk process allows you to identify each risk, quantify the impact, and take action to prevent it from occurring and reduce its impact. This process helps in placing the right processes for managing the risk. Perform procurement management. The procurement management process manages the procurement process, a method by which items are purchased from external suppliers. The procurement management process deals in managing the supplier relations by managing the ordering, receipt, review, and approval of items from suppliers, and immediately resolving any issue which arises with the supplier to keep uninterrupted supply. Next phase, which we will discuss, is project closure. The closeout phase or closing of the project represents the final stage of the project. In this phase, the project comes to closure. This phase involves delivering the project deliverables to the client, passing the documents to the business, returning of project staff to their respective departments, informing the stakeholders about the closing of the project, and closure of the project office. Herein, as the project is closed, so the scrutiny of the project is required. The steps followed in this phase are: perform the project closure. That is, the project control report is prepared to formally close the project. It describes how you intend to close your project. The reports confirm the meeting of project objectives. Handing over the deliverables in order to gain an agreement from the sponsor that the project is ready for the closure, to perform the closure activity effectively. Project completion review. The project completion review is the last step in the project lifecycle process. An independent party performs project review by identifying the project successes, deliverables, and achievements to validate the success of the project and to give confidence to the stakeholders that it has met the objectives it sets to achieve. The last phase is evaluation. This stage evaluates the results of the project after its completion to assess its performance. It answers few questions like, has the project been successful in achieving its objectives? If not, what are the reasons for its failure? If there is any scope for the improvement in the processes, was it delivered in given timelines? Most of the funding agencies requires project audit as a mandatory activity wherein rate of return of the project is compared to its cost as well as its economic benefits. Evaluation therefore helps to find out strengths, weaknesses, success and failure of the project. The results are valuable in planning the future projects and avoiding the mistakes. Thus, the results of the evaluation process needs to be disseminated. Next, we will discuss knowledge and skill, that is the essence of project life cycle. The knowledge and skill are regarded as the essence of any project life cycle. The amount of resources and the skill needed during any phase depends on the profile of the project. For example, a project with high complexity requires specialized skill and resources during the initial phase. Similarly, the technology transfer projects are typical projects which require specialized knowledge and skill at the initial stage of the project, and later the execution phase runs smoothly if a lot of energy is infused during initial period. Project with profile that involves the issue of coordination among the key stakeholders and political or legal environment will require specialized resources to develop plans that addresses these issues early in the project. A project with lower complexity level will invest more resources in the execution phase to complete the project as effectively and efficiently as possible, like training projects.
Let us summarize. Project life cycle refers to logical sequence of activities to accomplish project's goals. Irrespective of size and complexity, all projects map to the following life cycle stages, wherein each stage represents grouping of similar activities which leads towards effective working as well as effective arrangement of resources by project managers for each stage. It also helps in effective measurement of objectives and justify their decisions to move ahead, correct or terminate. There are six major stages of project. These include identification, initiation, project planning and appraisal, project execution, project closure and evaluation. The knowledge and skill are regarded as the essence of any project life cycle. The amount of resources and the skill needed during any phase depends on the profile of the project.